Back in my modeling days, I felt nothing less than Carrie Bradshaw. Although my shoe closet was maybe 1/4 of hers, I had over 80 pairs of shoes. For the lack of space, they were cramped up over one another. As my family grew and my priorities changed, my shoe closet became smaller. And although even now my love for shoes is intact, I have become wiser and shortlisted these 10 must-have shoes. I call them essentials because even if you have just these 10 shoes, you really won't need anything more in your shoe closet to match any outfit. After all, it's not just the budget, but also the space to keep these shoes that's very important to consider before you jump and buy the next shoe trend. If you are going to chase your dreams, do it in the cutest shoes. Welcome to Blush With Me. I shot most of today's video at Ann Taylor, Michigan Avenue, because I wanted to show you not just what I own, but also more options in similar categories. Let's start with these Nude Ballet flats or skimmer flats. Now, these are absolutely no fuss solution to looking polished and pulled together while you're on the go. They're equal part ladylike and casual, meaning you can wear them with pretty pleated skirts, shift dresses, or even jeans. But these come off in elevator, and just before you're about to enter your office or party, I slip into my black pumps. Black pumps. You knew this one was coming. You can never go wrong with a classic pair of black pumps. But keep listening to my take on this one. Invest on a high quality pair now and you'll have them for the next decade. These shoes look great with everything and they will take you from office to your night out. Throw on your black heels with any outfit and pull your whole look together, giving it a very chic vibe instantly. Now, not many of us can physically handle the pain that comes as a package deal with these guys, which is why wedges or these wider heels give you all the fashion points without all that wobbling in stilettos. These are great for days when you know you'll be walking a lot. As per your lifestyle, you can even opt for stacked short heels, like these ones. Next are loafers. Loafers in black, tan, and white are most essential for me. They have become my wardrobe mainstay. Think of these as an office to off-duty alternative to sneakers with a preppy cool twist. I personally enjoy closed shoes in front and back, but if you enjoy back openings for summer, mules are a great option too. Like these colorful ones from Ann Taylor. Statement shoes. Wear your statement shoes out anytime you're feeling a little more daring. Statement heels can be anything and everything, and they should be tailored to your style. Leather, suede, bright, bold, or studded, anything goes. But one thing they must be is unique. A good pair of statement heels will make even the simplest ensemble look brand new. So go ahead and throw your statement heels on and rock them with confidence. Nude heels. Nude heels with ankle straps. Now they are a no-brainer for completing our evening looks as well as a dressier day on some. They're seasonless and they go with everything and pull WT lengthening to our legs.
Or even shoes like these that are much thicker and broader in front that actually make you feel like you're wearing long, tall heels. You don't feel the pinch of them.
Riding boots. Yes, riding boots. These are perfect for when the weather gets a little chillier and you want to cover up, but you still want to look fashionable. These are truly an essential to any woman's wardrobe because they are like blank canvas. There's absolutely no debate about them. Let me explain. Most shoes nowadays have very contrasting elements, such as heels versus flat, pointy versus open toe, slim versus regular. My riding boots are from Echo and I've owned them since last 3 years. And I literally wear them in every fall, winter, and spring. Riding boots are just simply riding boots. They do not have to follow any trends. They're all uniform, tall, flat, and neutral color. They're classic and forever in style. And they're weatherproof. So I'm all set. Next are ankle boots. Yes, booties are important. I repeat, booties are important. I actually prefer booties over heels because they're more comfortable and they can be worn in any season. I wear mine casually, play dates, for family get-togethers, Although they are a bit more casual than heels, they complement almost any outfit.
What did I do before booties?
Oh yeah, I would come home after a long night out with sore, blister-ridden feet. As I said, ankle booties have served me well. Espadrilles. Ditch sneakers? Not really. But try these instead of your basic white sneakers and watch your look elevate. These are super comfy too. I have to admit that I do avoid espadrille platform wedge sandals. Now, wedges are supposed to elongate your look, but for some reason, this one kind of shoe just makes your feet look very bulky and just does not add the height in a very flattering manner. Workout trainers. We all own one of these if you work out. But in the last couple of years, some new streetwear styles of sneakers have come up in the market. Every time I ask these brands if I could work out in them, they say no, these are just street style. They're called athleisure shoes. I wanted something that worked great for me in the gym and also looked great on street. I personally love these Under Armour's Hovr Phantom shoes. They are perfect for my heel support. Everyone in my family wears them. Now my in-laws, my husband, my mom, because they say these are the most supportive and cushioning shoes ever. They're the only shoes that work great with and without laces, which means super stylish streetwear. I love tank shoelaces. Said no one ever. So these Hovr Phantom from Under Armour could be your next best workout shoes as well as athleisure shoes. And if you are looking for a glam athleisure style that actually adds height to you, then try these Michale Kors slip-on sneakers. Sandals, everyday sandals. Now think of these as your much cooler alternatives to flip-flops. Since we all gravitate towards flat sandals all summer long, make sure you're up for a pair with details that you'll be happy to slip into on a daily basis. So these are my must-haves. I also showed you some options that may suit your personality and your lifestyle better. In my last video about how you should plan your shopping as per your personality, I showed you my bright yellow tots that I have worn most frequently in the last 10 years. And they still look timeless and brand new. And to me, they are basic. Click up here to see that video. This was my way to guide you. Now you get ready to go places because that's what good shoes do, right? Now, if you have something you want to add to this list, something that's been your favorite go-to shoe, then I want to know all about it. Write to me in the comments below. Share this video with your friends who could use some help. Follow me on my Instagram and Facebook fan page accounts because that's where I post most frequently and also announce some giveaways. It's time for me to pack up now because I am heading on an Alaska trip to make an amazing video just for you guys. How to take photos of yourself when you travel. How does that sound? Stick around with me for some more amazing new ideas to upgrade your selfies. Until next week, blush with me.